Hello, in this video I'll be presenting to you how the AutoZLounge extension works. The version of the extension that I'm using for this video is 0.2. Please note that there might be a newer version that has more features and improvements that is already available, but will not be shown in this video. As you see, I have the AutoZLounge extension enabled. Upon clicking on the icon, a pop-up panel will open. Here you can set the filters and also search for the items of a specific campaign using its ID. You can filter by brand, type, color, collection, size, and price range. Please also note that newer versions of this extension will have better filtering based on grouping, which should be explained upon release of the improved filtering. Before you can use the extension, we need to set some filters. A star represents that we want everything from that filter category. Let's delete this star and enter some brand that we'd want. For example, Lyle and Scott. If the brand name has more than just one word, then it's safer to just enter one word from that brand. So in this case, I'll just enter Lyle. We can also enter whatever other brands we'd like. Whenever we finish entering the brands we want, be sure to hit the save button. For the next filter category, I'll open up a campaign page for a better example. Here are some products of a campaign. As you see, they have their brand name showed, but in a situation where the campaign is brand specific, then the brand itself won't show. Instead, usually a collection name is visible instead. Now we'll enter the product type. It can be a dress, t-shirt, and so on. Let's write the product type inside the appropriate box. We can enter the full product type name or just simply one word from it. I'll also enter the product brand so we can test the filter out later. And let's delete the other brands and leave that one by itself. Now we can enter the product color, which is a word representing the color. Please also remember to save your filters each time before closing the pop-up box, because as you see, I forgot to save it and all my changes have been discarded. Here you can enter the collection name. I'll just leave a star here, so we'll be accepting any collection name. We also should enter the size. Let's say I want 34 because I know it's available. You can enter as many sizes as you want, like in other filters. The last thing is the price range. Let's just set it to something between the actual price of the product. Now you can either go to the campaign page and the filter will work by itself or use the campaign ID to enter it inside the pop-up. This is most likely the fastest way because it does not require you to load the actual campaign page. Whenever the search ends, we'll get notified how many items have been added to the basket. So let's check our basket. As you see, we have the item we wanted in our basket. If there was any more items that matched our filters, then of course those would also be added to our basket. Please note that there is a limit of 30 items in the basket. That would be it for this video. Feel free to ask questions, give feedback, and suggestions in the comment section of this video. Have a nice day.